And I'd like to advise that this meeting of the committee will be streamed live to the City of Adelaide website and Facebook page. A recording will also be published to the internet. Please note that this audio visual recording means that your presence at any contribution you make to the meeting may be collected, used, disclosed, or published publicly by the council, including transferring outside of Australia. Council acknowledges that we are meeting on traditional country of the Kaurna people of the Adelaide Plains and pay respect to their elders past and present. We recognise and respect their cultural heritage, beliefs, and relationship with the land. We acknowledge they are of continuing importance to the Kaurna people living today. And we also extend that respect to other Aboriginal language groups and other First Nations who are present today. I have an apology from Councillor Sims, but it seems other than that we're all very much accounted for. Confirmation of the minutes, can I have someone move that there is an accurate record? Councillor Kira, seconded Councillor Ibrahim today. Members, put that to the vote. Those in favour? Those against? That is carried. We'll go to item four, CEO update. Mark.
Thanks, Chair. As you can see, we've got two items tonight that can be presented by Tom with his tie on. First of all, we have the CEO update in open agenda. We have Adelaide to Connacht Street as the first item, followed by Telstra the second item. I just want to explain why we need to move from open agenda then into closed agenda. I hope you can see from the agenda tonight that we intend to discuss all that we can in open agenda at the outset with Tom presenting, and then we'll need to go into the confidential session. Ada O'Connell Street, we're going to have some guests to present to you. As you know, we are yet to sign the heads of agreement, so we can't talk to you in open agenda. That's something that we've taken very seriously. We also have, with regard to Telstra matter, received some legal advice that we need to discuss with you, and there's also some commercial aspects too. So in my view, both those matters deserve to go into confidence, but we will do whatever we can to discuss the open agenda items as fully as possible that Tom's going to lead you through. Hand over to Tom. Thanks, Chair.
Thank you. Tom.
Through you, Chair. First of all, happy St. Patrick's Day. So just to provide you with some insight, we're talking about 88 O'Connell Street first. As you're aware, Council on the 19th of November 2019 selected a preferred opponent to progress negotiations in regards to redevelopment of the site. We've now entered into a stage which is commercially sensitive in terms of negotiating the conditions of that agreement and also the final design outcomes, which will then flow back into the agreement itself. It's both contractual and commercial conditions with the nominated developer, and we've actually entered into a non-disclosure agreement with that developer until such times as we're ready to come out in public with that information. It also protects us in regards to any potential leakage out in the media. This process is to ensure we achieve optimal outcome for all City of Adelaide residents, business owners and ratepayers. We're working hard to finalise the negotiations so we can share the concepts with the community in 2020. And we remain on track to ensure that construction on site commences in early 2022. Just a quick one, also just separate to the development, just the activation, I thought it's appropriate just to bring you up to speed in regards to what we're doing this in that space. As you're aware, we installed an asphalt surface to one third of the car park for the 60 plus spaces plus disabled spaces. That was in response to the, we were concerned during the dry period, dust and whatever, and we were putting various treatments down to suppress that dust, but we were unsuccessful, so we basically decided to do that, and we've had positive responses from the businesses and residents in close proximity. We've done two twilight markets were held on site during December. In January 2020, a number of sprinkler sessions were held as part of school holidays to bring in naturally a lot of children and families into that site. A number of movie nights were held during February, along with, as you can see, Faded Behind, The Love Bug, and naturally that was supported by art installations on site as well. On Sunday, the 5th of April, we're hosting a picnic party as part of the first ever Adelaide Food Fringe. We're very mindful of the current conditions that are happening at the minute in regards to coronavirus and stuff like that, so we will take advice, but at this present time, we're planning to proceed with that until we're advised. I guess if we're not planning mass gatherings, normally what happens is it's small groups of people come in and out during the day, but we will monitor that up until that period. This event is presented by the City of Adelaide and supported by Parrot Life, and naturally aims to support local street traders and will include local food, picnic snacks, pop-up bars, live music, food, workshops and demonstrations, so on and so forth. In regards to the Telstra Smart Hub, if Council would remember, in September 2018, we brought a report to Council where we were approached by JC Deco, who are the basically the advertiser and marketer for Telstra. Telstra at that stage are rolling out their Smart Hub payphones, and they're doing that across Australia. So it's their next generation payphones, and they will be replacing every payphone within Australia. The smartphone payphones or Smart Hub incorporate digital advertising panel and will initially advertise Telstra related products. But Telstra proposes to advertise services and products which are unrelated to Telstra, i.e. third-party advertising in the future. So at present, Telstra under the low-impact facilities under the Act, they can actually advertise their own products and whatever on their own apparatus and equipment. So effectively what they're wishing to do is to install within the City of Adelaide, which would be install, operate and maintain of low impact facilities and they don't require state or local government planning approvals effectively. Telstra's lodged, but what they have done is lodged development applications seeking approvals to change the content of digital signage panels to display products and services unrelated to Telstra. Telstra, in partnership with JC Deco, have lodged approximately 50 development applications at various sites throughout the City of Adelaide and North Adelaide. Planning consent was sought for the change in nature of advertising content, and naturally our planning people went through that. To date, approximately 40 applications have been assessed and granted development approval through our CAP. All the time of writing this paper, only one Smart Hub has been installed. So if you actually go to Grove Street, not far from where Kennard's Hire is, you'll see one of the new Smart Hubs there, which is currently advertising Telstra advertising. When we presented in September, as you're aware, September 2018, the City of Melbourne had grave concerns in regards to the potential rollout of these Telstra Smart Hub payphones. At that stage, it was more about planning control, and it was also to do with scale. Naturally, they were also concerned about third-party advertising. So effectively, what has happened is that has went out to the Supreme Court, and the Melbourne City Council actually challenged Telstra's right under the Telecommunications Act, effectively saying that the low-impact facilities shouldn't be warranted and they need to be adjusted. In other words, the Council could say no. So effectively, that determination has went through. City of Sydney joined with them, City of Brisbane sought permission and joined, so there was a tripartite push against Telstra. And in the 10th of March 2020, Telstra were successful and the councils were not successful. So effectively that means that they can put these pieces of equipment in the ground with the digital panel advertising Telstra products and whatever on. And the basis of the further report that we may do in context is about talking these through what is possible, what is not possible in regards to that. Thank you.
We'll open it up for questions on that content that's just been delivered. Councillor Kirby.
Just how big and bright are the screens on these payphones?
If you look in the base, sorry, through your presiding member, in the basis of your report, you will actually see one of the drawings. So they're effectively about 2.5 metres in height. That's not the full screen, but that's the height of the apparatus itself by about 1.3 or whatever. What it's not only advertising, what Telstra are trying to achieve through the smart hubs is 5G. So this booth or smart hub has been built in a way that can house 5G apparatus and equipment. And what they're trying to do is effectively get all the locations throughout the city, CBD and North Adelaide.
So on the screens, the advertising on these screens, are they intended to be advertising for simply the user of the phone, or is it more like billboard advertising for people across the road and whatever is that?
Through your society member, the current way that they're operating is advertising Telstra only products. However, their intent is to seek third party advertising and to actually progress with that. Another thing to bear in mind is this has DIPTI put a stay on any installations in regards to South Australia. The reason being is that they want to make sure that the apparatus is compliant to the Road Traffic Act, and Telstra had to basically write a thesis to turn around, say how these are going to operate in the public realm, how they're going to be angled, and basically talk about light emissions and also visibility to ongoing traffic, so on and so forth, and that has now been approved by DIPTI.
Does that include attenuation of light intensity at night time?
That would include both day and night time, any sort of light emission from the product. And they've also, what they've done is they've moved what is a traditional, I'll call it a lag time in advertising, where it used to be 6 ads every 10 seconds to 1 ad every 45 seconds.
So what, just a blank screen otherwise?
So no, effectively an ad would be on for 45 seconds and basically that's it, and then they would move to another ad.
Further questions on the side? Councillor Donnelly.
How does advertising revenue that they've proposed compare to other similar advertisers like bus stops or those sorts of things?
I can't refer to bus stops and whatever because we're commercial in confidence or contractor. However, we have gauged the revenue potential from these sites. What we haven't gauged is with the changes moving from 6 ads every 10 seconds to 1 ad every 45 seconds, what the impact is to the revenue stream. However, it's not dissimilar. We're talking the bus stops, we have more, so the revenues there and thereabouts.
So the rate is comparable?
The rate is comparable.
Members? Okay, thank you, Mark, and thank you, Tom, for that. We'll move to item 5.1, exclusion of the public to consider in confidence items 6.1 and 6.2. We'll deal with item 6.1 first, the workshop on ADA for O'Connell. Can I have a move for that? Thank you, Lord Mayor, seconded by Councillor Kouros. Lord Mayor, do you wish to speak? Councillor Kouros. Councillor Martin.
Yes, Chair, I'd like to oppose being heard in confidence. This is a matter of great public interest. Any reading of the papers will demonstrate that there's nothing much different in the papers that are confidential to what we've just heard from Tom. Moreover, there is a degree of speculation about this project fed not only by the advertiser but by InDaily. And unless the proponents are coming in here wearing paper bags over their heads, their appearance will be reported. It is apparently a matter of open speculation among media that it is easy to find out who we're talking to by simply standing outside the council building, watching who leaves and who enters. I just see no point in continuing this charade. If we were talking about the signing of a particular document, then that, I would understand, could be argued, is a matter that ought to be commercial in confidence. But this is not what this discussion is about. And therefore, I will oppose this, and I urge every member to oppose it.
Tom, can I just get your advice on the matter that's in the confidential report as it compares to the update that you just delivered?
Three presiding member taking on board Councillor Martin's comments. What will be presented tonight will be tabled. It was only finished at 3 o'clock today. They've been working avidly in regards to taking council's feedback and turn that into design outcomes. So what you'll be hearing tonight is new design related material similar to the last time that was presented, where you start to shape the narrative in regards to the conversation. It has a major impact in regards to any commercial negotiations. It also has a major impact in any contractual negotiations. Just to also emphasize, I did highlight the start, we've entered into a non-disclosure agreement with the parties. So in effect, what we're trying to do is control that information. Whilst I note what Councillor Martin has said about the media, we can't control speculation. And all that I say is what we're trying to do is keep this as tight as possible, and we will apply it with the straight spot.
Thank you. Councillor Moran.
Yes, well,
my place, Council. It's still not on, sorry, is that operating?
What you're saying is that there's more stuff that we're going to get. Well, why is this stuff in peak pages? Why can't this go out, what we have provided to the proponent? What's the confidential in here?
Through you, presiding member, these are also discussions of when you, if you remember at the end of the last meeting when we were discussing this, we said we'd individually meet with elected members. We've captured that information and we've put that in and we started to feed that into the report for those who actually opted to meet with us. As I say, we're actually in a non-disclosure agreement with this party, and any information up until such times as council endorses either the heads of agreement and or the project development agreement, we have to stay in confidence.
Can I just get that here again? So we have had confidential workshops with everybody here, but you've met individually with councillors to shape this. That is very different to our usual, because there are things here that we certainly haven't discussed, but it's feedback provided to the proponent.
Through you, presiding member, at the end of the last meeting, there was a request in regards to sitting down with elected members. An open offer went out through the council office to all the elected members in regards to a meeting. Some elected members opted to meet. We basically referred them back to the five items that we were looking at from the first meeting and to ask them what their responses were to that. And that's how they've covered it off, quite simply within the basis of the report. The proponent has took that and they're starting to work on a different iteration of the design to assist council with their thought process.
So in other words, there have been individual, Councillor A has said, I don't want this, and it's gone in there.
Through you, presiding member, the offer was made to all elected members.
Yes.
Sorry.
Through the chair, this council meets together, so we all meet with our colleagues. One by one meetings, until this one, has been very frowned upon, as you know. I know the offer went out, but I didn't think...
Councillor, is there a question here, or should I start the clock?
You can start the clock. I didn't think that would just go straight into the feedback. I thought that you would talk to individual members and then we would come back together. But it appears to me that the feedback has come from now. The people over there have very different ideas to those which I have, and less understanding of the situation. So I don't meet individually with statements. I think that's a really dangerous thing to do. And we have frowned upon that quite justifiably. So I just register my complete horror that this, I've never seen these things before.
Just in response to that.
Thank you, Councillor. Can I just ask you to clarify as well? It's my understanding that this is us coming back together.
That is exactly
okay. Well, I will clarify that there is a page here that identifies...
Councillor, are you seeking clarification on something or are you speaking again?
You just asked a question then and I'm answering it.
I asked Tom. He's since clarified and I'm grateful for it. If you have a further question, you may ask it, but you may not address us
again. Individual inputs, have they already been put to the proponent?
Through you, presiding member, we've discussed the design intent in regards to the feedback from the presentation and what you see before you in regards to the councillors. And if the councillors wish, they can actually say who they were. We've provided that response. It is in keeping with all the discussions we've had. There is nothing in there which is saying effectively stop doing it, it's progressing the design. The comments that were made were not dissimilar to any of the comments we've had in any of the briefing sessions about greening, about shadowing, about attraction, about activation of the site and visitation, and what it's going to do for North Adelaide. And that's what we've intended to cover. I'll be guided by council if they wish to respond.
Well, just to finish off my 3 minutes, I'm very disappointed. I mean, so I could have gone to...
Councillor, you've already finished speaking.
Well, I don't think I have. I don't think I've had 3 minutes. So I could go to Tom and say I want it to be 45 stories tall, and that would have been in here. Is that right?
Councillor, through you, presiding member, one of the things that we went to the elected members as required was to respond to the five items that was the basis of the first meeting, and we didn't talk scale at all. Some of the elected members certainly mentioned scale, but if you look from the report, that is not contained within that. Knowing that council made a resolution with this proponent to proceed on the basis of the design that was already there based on the scale and dimensions of the development.
Members, if not, we'll move back to the move to sum up. That to the vote, those in favour? Those opposed? Councillors Moran and Martin, are you voting with us this evening?
No, we're voting against.
Yeah,
I'll have to put that again. Those in favour? Those opposed? That's a cue. Thank you. That is carried. With that, we'll move on to the confidentiality order for item 6.2, the telecommunications hub. I see you can move it in a seconder. Thank you, Councillor Ibrahimzadeh. Seconded by Councillor Noel. Councillor Ibrahimzadeh, do you wish to speak? Councillor Noel? Members?
Yes, again, Chair, I do appreciate the administration putting part of this in the public realm. But again, in reading the papers, the only information that is missing is financial information that is related to a contractual agreement that is not going to fall over if the matter is in public. It is just a fact, just as we know how much revenue is arising from different sources, so we know with this document. I just don't see the point in keeping this confidential.
Tom, was there something you wish to clarify there?
Through you, presiding member, naturally, if council is approached in regards to any sort of commercial offer, that commercial offer is done between the City of Adelaide and the proponent. It is confidential in nature until such times as council either enters into agreement or declines that agreement. Also, what we're talking about is other items within the report which talk to certain acts or the act and looking at permits on the road reserve and around the footpath. That is the decision of council in regards to this, and they need to consider that pretty carefully. So we've actually joined that together so that you can think in regards to a way to actually move forward.
And so part of what you're saying there is we'll be getting legal advices for that work.
We've got a legal provider coming in.
Councillor Martin, another question?
Yes, I have a question. Has the other party involved in the documentation before us tonight requested the map be held in confidence? It certainly doesn't say confidential in the correspondence.
Through you, presiding member, the offer itself is commercial in confidence until such times as council determines. Just to highlight in regards to the offer it's proposed or presented in front of council, this is unique to the City of Adelaide, not unique to any other council in the other capital city, and it needs to be treated like that, it needs to be treated in confidence, and I would believe that the proponent would actually request it.
Thank you. Members, any further contributions? If not, I'll go back to the move to sum up. Councillor, put that to the vote. Those in favour? Those opposed? That is carried. Members of the gallery and staff, thank you for your attendance at this meeting. For those of you who The meeting is now closed.